Perhaps you've seen a video like this one that seems to show the waves present when guitar strings are strummed. In reality, though, guitar strings vibrate predominantly at their fundamental mode. The wave effect that we see is the result of how the camera's sensor forms each frame. Instead of taking snapshots, the camera progressively scans the data across the sensor. Since the scanning frequency and vibrational frequencies are mismatched, this can lead to the appearance of standing waves. But what does a vibrating guitar string actually look like? To see this, I assembled a strobe light with some parts I had laying around. A simple program then allows me to dial in any frequency on the fly. The purpose of the strobe light is to freeze time without needing an expensive high-speed camera. Things get rather interesting when the strobe frequency is matched to some periodic motion. In this example, the scene is only illuminated at the peak amplitudes. This actually happens so fast that we see a wave apparently frozen in time. If we offset the frequency just slightly, we can get the appearance of slow motion. One neat result is that we can now use the strobe light to tune a guitar. When the note's a little flat, like in this case, the string moves slowly, but as we get closer and closer to the target note, that motion ceases. Though the fundamental mode dominates, there are other modes present on any vibrating string. We can explore these with a simple cotton string fixed at one end and attached to a speaker on the other. In this case, the strobe is flashing at twice the frequency of the string resonance. If we match the strobe frequency, we see the wave in only one position. There actually are higher frequency modes that we can isolate by progressively decreasing the string tension. These are called overtones of the fundamental, and we can see them without changing the strobe frequency because they were always integer multiples of the fundamental. Resonance is a property of all materials, and the wine glass is a classic example. The wetted finger trick induces this resonance, and we can see it by carefully matching the strobe light. Now, I wanted to shatter this wine glass, and to do that, I needed a hammer. I mean, I needed science. After grabbing some science, I recorded the tone, brought it in the MATLAB, and did a Fourier analysis to find the dominant frequency. Once found, we can verify our work by listening to the two tones. Then it's just a simple matter of cranking up the volume. Wow, that was neato. It's not at all surprising that the glass shattered, when you consider the fact that this glass was vibrating at over 400 times a second, and the amplitude was significant as we could see in the video. Liquids will resonate too, and because they have more degrees of freedom than a simple string, they accordingly have more ways in which to resonate. Things here do get much more complicated, and I even have a former colleague that spent an entire PhD studying droplets like these. But it's still interesting to tinker in seeing how changing the material properties changes the resonance. For example, like changing the tension on the string, we can change the size of the droplet, and in this way we affect its resonance. Proper treatment of this subject is far beyond the scope of my tolerance for Green's functions and the purpose of this video. Now I do have more plans for my strobe light, but those are going to have to wait for another video. In the meantime, check out some other videos I've put together and stay tuned for more to come.